Singapore's property market may see prices climb more slowly next year as home buyers stay prudent in uncertain times and more supply enters the market. Analysts anticipate prices to increase by up to 8% compared with up to 11% projected for this year. Rebecca Mateo reports on what this could mean for buyers biding their time.
$1.3 million. That's what one four-room flat in Pinnacle at Duxton fetched in October. Flats like that have been grabbing headlines all year, and property analysts say as many as 370 resale flats could be sold for at least $1 million by the end of 2022. Even non-mature estates are seeing units sold in this price range, with 13 flats in these estates across the country selling above $1 million.
For HDB, resale market has increased by 8% just over the past 9 months. Although prices have been rising, we do see that demand is still quite strong, mainly because in the beginning of this year, we have lifted up most of the border measures.
To moderate demand for resale flats, the government in September introduced a fresh round of cooling measures. They include a requirement for private homeowners looking to buy HDB flats to wait 15 months after the sale of their current private property before they can make the purchase.
That policy is very important, especially to insulate resale HDB market from these investment demands or from people who downgrade. So at least the first timer or those genuine homeowner will be able to actually have a chance to actually buy the resale HDB flat.
But the measure is creating headaches for home buyers caught in limbo. Lai Wai Kit was looking to move his family to an HDB flat nearer his children's schools. He sold his private home before the wait-up period and before finding a resale flat.
We were much more serious in terms of looking at HDBs, going down, placing offers. We extended a couple of offers. But all that homework, so to speak, right, sort of now parked, and we need to redo the homework now for private housing instead.
Due to hand over their current home to new owners early next year, the family will have to rent in the interim, in a market where rental prices for public and private homes are already at record highs.
Rental market has been very strong over the past year, mainly because of many foreigners returning, students coming back, and of course Singaporeans who are relocating back to Singapore. So they were renting in the interim while they are waiting to buy a new home.
And buying a new home is also increasingly out of reach in a private property market that keeps getting hotter and hotter.
Prices keep going up because there are willing buyers. Prices of private residences grew by as much as 8.2% in the first three quarters of this year. But demand has been so intense that several new private property launches in the suburban region saw more than 80% of the units snapped up in the first 2 days of launch, as was the case here at Lanta Modern.
This despite a price tag of around $2,000 per square foot, a range that analysts expect will continue well into next year.
Next year, we will see more new launches, and so the new sale demand will be higher. The developers are not expected to sell at that 75-90% rate in the first weekend of launch. Maybe it may fall back to something 50%. Or 60% if they are priced within range for their respective locations.
But higher mortgages and tighter limits on property loans could slow down price increases. As such, market watchers expect the property market to stabilize, especially as buyers also hold back in the face of economic uncertainty and as more homes become available.
We don't expect the price to grow as strong as what we've seen in this current years and the last years. So moving forward, I think there will be uneven distribution in terms of price trends, depending on the supply coming on the market.
Those in the industry say housing prices will likely grow at a more moderate rate of 5-8% next year. And that could give the market more breathing space and prospective home buyers more room to maneuver.